வணக்கம், மை ஹைதர் அலி சையத் ஆசிர்வாதம் சே யுனைடெட் அண்டர் தமிழ் சேவா. சூரே ஃபாத்தியா, த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் சாப்டர் ஆஃப் குரான், இஸ் பீன் ரிசைட்டட் பை 1.6 பில்லியன் முஸ்லிம் ஆல் ஓவர் த வேர்ல்ட். 5 டைம்ஸ் அ டே தே ரிசைட் சூரே ஃபாத்தியா 38 டைம்ஸ் பர் டே. Do this 1.6 billion so-called Muslim really understand the meaning of Surah Fatiha, the first chapter of Quran? Or they simply standing behind their priestly cult, Maulana, blindfolded? Come, let us understand the true meaning and explanation of Surah Fatiha, the first chapter of Quran, recited by 1.6 billion so-called Muslim 38 times per day. Quran chapter 1, Surah Fatiha, I read. All praises is to Almighty, the Lord of the world, the most gracious, the most merciful, the owner of the day of recompense. I explain. What is the day of recompense? The day of recompense is the day of judgment, the day in which we will all return to our Lord to be judged for a time here on earth. Quran chapter 7 verse 172 to 174. Here in these verses, Allah reminds that all humans from descendants of Adam testified with Allah for being obedient to the law of Allah when on earth. I read Quran chapter 7 verse 172 and 173. And remember when your Lord brought forth the generation from the backs of the descendant of Adam and made them their own witness. Am I not your Lord? They all said, yes, surely you are. Why not? We testify. For you may say on the day of resurrection that we were not aware, we were unaware of this. Or you may say it is our ancestors who first ascribed partners to Almighty or broke commandment, and we were their children after them. So will you, Allah, destroy us on account of their deeds of the followers of falsehood? Remember, the day of recompense for all will take place on the day of judgment. Prior to judgment day, all dead, their soul is kept in ancestral plane, in other words, Alam-e-Barzakh. Quran chapter 23 verse 99 to 104, it clearly says that dead people's soul cannot return to earth. But here, under one of the principle of Varna Dharam, the priestly cult have introduced Shraad and Pitri. Under Shraad and Pitri, these priestly cult, they sending foods and sending blessing to dead people's soul for Atma Shanti. Similar concept is adopted by the other priestly cult under Muslim label. They call Shraad and Pitri, concept of Varna Dharam, and call it Isai Sawab. Many rich and poor people fall into the web of lie of priestly cult who represent Varna Dharam. Thus the rich donating money, property to this fraud priestly cult who are playing with the emotions of the people in the name of death and sending blessing to the Atma for Atma Shanti. The rich, instead of giving money, property to their poor relatives, these rich people are donating to fraud priestly cult, thus making priestly cult strong, encouraging them to spread their web of lies under Varna Dharam. Remember, under Asivagam, the real Islam, under it, priestly cult are not entertained. There is no place for priesthood in Asivagam, the real Islam. Quran, verse 4 of chapter 1, further says, I read, you alone we worship and you alone we seek help. Question here is, when priestly cult falls under the category of Varna Dharam, the Antichrist Messiah Dajjal system, why people are wasting their time behind this fraud group? Remember, standing behind elected minister, Khalifa, is Islam. Still these so-called 1.6 billion blindly standing behind Maulana Hafiz Ulama Alim. Remember, short namaz based on Burak Hadith of Bukhari goes against Quran. What is the mode of worship in real Islam? That is Asivagam. You alone we worship and you alone we seek help. Does God needs any intermediator? Remember, the practice of Shraad and Pitri and Isai Sawab or Yagna or standing behind Maulana or short namaz based on Burak Hadith, which goes against Quran, mankind does not require any mediator or priestly cult. Does God depends on priestly cult to connect with his creation? Under Asivagam mode of worship, which is meditation and yoga, following healthy mind, healthy body concept. Mind is nothing but soul. What is soul? Soul is God's particle. Through Kundalini awakening, one can activate God's particle, in other words, Atma or soul, and get connected to Paramatma or higher conscious instead of wasting time behind priestly cult who are the protector of one-eyed system of Varna Dharam and Manu Shastra. One should sit in meditation and do yoga to activate Kundalini chakra and for connecting to higher conscious. One does not require any intermediator or priestly cult. Remember, in Bible, God says mankind has been created in his own image. Every human is in the image of God, having God's particle. So why degrade our own soul by following the fake priestly cult who represent syndicate of elites under Varna Dharam, now syndicate of global elites under one world order, one world religion. I read further, verse 5 and 6 of chapter 1 of Quran Surah Fatiha, I read, guide us on the straight path, the path of those whom you have favored. Guide us on the straight path refers to the path which has been thought by pen to the first Siddhar by Almighty, giving him information on all subjects. That straight path is called Asivagam, the real Islam, the path of those whom you have favored. God favored the blessed DNA of Shiva, alias Seth. Biblical term for Shiva is Seth, royal bloodline of Seth, alias Shiva. Quran chapter 2 verse 30 prophesies about the vicegerent in succession on earth, referring to royal bloodline of Seth, alias Shiva. As per Tamil tradition, Shiva is the first Siddhar and the first administrator of the world, appointed by Almighty. Term appointed in Hebrew language means Seth. I read further, verse 7 of chapter 1 of Quran Surah Fatiha, not the part of those who earn your anger, nor of the astray. The part of those who earn your anger refers to the first son of Adam called Cain. Cain, who established the first murder on earth. Cain was cursed and banished from the cradle of civilization. Cradle of civilization is Tamil Nadu, Sri Lanka, Kumari Khandam. Bible regarding Cain says, restless wanderer on the earth with a sign. Generation of Cain lived in cave among pigs and dogs. Cain generation followed the concept of survival of the fittest, as they had no law, no civilization. Generation of Cain followed the culture of sex, food and violence. Children of Cain were hunter-gatherer society. When there was scarcity of animal, they used to eat their own people, weak and old, including children. Children of Cain were cannibals. They indulged in gay act, animal sex, group sex, child sex. Cain generation were barbaric people until recently. Not the part of those whom earn your anger. This line of Quran refers to children of Cain, the murderer. Quran chapter 1 concludes, it says, I read, nor of the astray. Who are the astray people among the Tamil nation who once followed and lived under the principle of Asivagam, the real Islam? Remember, from one male and one female, God has created nations and tribes. So one can identify by color, race and tribe. Mankind is divided into color or race. Race is further divided into many tribes. Each tribe people are involved under four categories of profession or caste. They are learned, administrator, corporate and labor. Under Asivagam principle, all professions were living in peace, harmony, brotherhood and with balance under the law of equality which was given to first Siddhar. Remember, balance among all profession was possible as common people took active part in administration along the side of elected king or minister, thus making policies for welfare of all tribes and caste and profession. Koil means house of elected king. Koil, a parliament. Under Asivagam principle, Tamil nation lived in golden era until the coming of Antichrist. Remember, Cain is the first Antichrist. Coming of Antichrist, Messiah Dajjal, refers to first batch of children of Cain, tribe Persian Aryans, coming down to Tamil nation. Tamil nation boundaries after deluge starts from Turkey to Indus Valley, Kashmir, Nalanda, Bihar, Bangladesh, Tamil Nadu, Sri Lanka, Cambodia, Thailand up to Australia. Remember, Aryan migration was made easy due to Mahabharat war, where Tamil Shiva Pandyan dynasty collapsed due to in-house fighting. This war took place from the region of Turkey to Indus Valley, Rajasthan, Gujarat. Thus, Antichrist Messiah Dajjal, the first batch of Persian Aryan, faced no resistance from natives. Black Tamil. Later, elites among Tamil nation surrendered to barbaric Aryan settlers. And later, together, they introduced Varna Dharam, the one-eyed system. Varna Dharam, a religion created by elites of corrupted natives Tamil and Persian Aryan settlers. Natives who were living in golden era under Asivagam principle, they were pushed into the era of untouchability. By their own people holding position in elites profession
who got influenced by Persian Aryan settlers. Thus, the elites among the natives strayed from the path of Asivagam.
Vanakkam. Thank you.